Hello world, I am Attila here, and today I will talk about the Mystery of Capital book, and this was a very interesting book on how capitalism only succeeds in the West and fails everywhere else. So we look behind like the curtain at the reasons of this, and it's because like this book says that it's because like you have access to capital based on your land and your property. So the rights to possess something is clear. So it is clear for the authorities of who owns what, and the land is divided based on that. So everyone has access to, like, if you point out to a land, the authority will be able to say who owns that land. And because the mortgage is the primary source in the West to loan for entrepreneurs, so their house is like the biggest source, like their biggest property for most families. So entrepreneurs take loan based on that, and we are so used to it that we are not aware of it. So like it's like clear the rights to own something, and we have access to capital based on our possessions, and the legal entries to create a business is very low, so anyone can create a business, while in third world countries there are these huge extra legal sectors, which is like a huge part of the economy, and the government doesn't know anything about that. You can buy a house and you don't have to report it to the authority, so they don't know anything really. And if you want to like adapt capitalism, you must integrate your resources into an orderly legal framework. So the resources shouldn't be invisible for the government, because if it's invisible, you can take loan out on that, because like the banks don't see that you own debt, and this is debt capital. And currently 80% of all capital in the world is debt capital, so you can't take out capital on that. So that capital is like your land that the government don't know that you own. The government doesn't know that you own. So you must be able to obtain capital from your land, and to do that the government must know that you own that land. And like this is a conversion of assets to paper value. So capital results from the ability to represent resources in a virtual context. So like on paper it is written that you own a house that is worth around $20,000, and you can access to capital based on that value. So you won't be able to access like $100,000 based on your $20,000 house. So this is proportional. So if you want to fix your economy, because you happen to be a government of a third world country, there are three steps you must do. So first, you must organize information about assets into one system, so it should be clear. And second, people should be held accountable. So there is a name attached to every address, and because of that, like, people won't have anonymity, because in third world countries currently you can just disappear into the crowd and people can't find you. But with these systems, people do have access to your addresses. And the third, you must secure transactions. So people must trust in your system, and they must be able to transact in your system. And with these methods, people have access to capital and can start to create, because entrepreneurs' spirits are everywhere in every country. but they just can't create if they don't have capital, because they can't pay like their businesses from cash, so they must take out loans. And with this, you will have an enormous system. If you integrate everyone into this system, you will have an enormous system of your, of like property. And then this will have a network effect. So it says that the value of a network is its users squared. So like the more users you have, like the faster you will grow your users. So this is like a network effect. And European countries and America also had this problem. So there was this huge extra-legal sector. And like we used to have like guilds, and we didn't have like really free market. But then Europe converted this free market, and like throughout hundreds of years we adapted this property system that we use today, and like we converted into capitalism. Like it was a very gradual process, and it also explored how American law was created by a long evolution from the British law. So in the beginning there was like this huge mess, this wild west in America for a long time. Like this was this gun right. Like if you had power, you were able to obtain your land. But then these people created social contracts among themselves. And like a law can stay alive by keeping in touch with this, with social contracts created within real people. So like a law in like deeply is just a social contract. And if you want to transform your third world country into capitalism, you must create a law based on existing social contracts. So these social contracts are like, we don't rob each other and things like that. That is really like represents the value of our country and the value in our, the values in our society. So this was it, and this was a very interesting book, and like I would like to convert a little bit this channel, because until now I mostly read about investing books and like this, and like there are hundreds of like these good books that I just have access to, and these are not like very famous, but I think if you listen to them you can like have access to information like invisible to others, because like this is about economy and capitalism, and we all live in capitalism, so it's like very interesting. So like you should subscribe and or follow me. I also have a Twitter account, I will put it here, and it's also in the link, and I have a YouTube channel, so you should check these out. Bye bye.